told you the results. Looking for hush money from me, you ain't gonna get it done. Historic, rain on my parade. I keep walking and ignore it. Just part of the game, yeah, it comes with the territory. It's just another day, man, I'm used to it downpouring. It's nothing. If I did it, then I did it right. This ain't happened for me overnight. Better guess me, you gon' pay the price. Business, I ain't playing nice. So I had it, y'all, I'm out of sight. When you poppin', they don't wanna slice. Read the envy, that's a part of life. Mediocre, that just won't suffice. Introduction. Style my own, can't no one touch it. Became what they said I couldn't. Mediocre, that won't cut it. Life is a gift, I wanna live it to the fullest while I can. Why? What a knock and a new my days in this game are. Might as well enjoy the few years that I do have left. Who knows? First I've been to hell and back ever since that first EP. I've been giving all I have. Wasn't really prepared for the pain I was gonna have to go through to get to the end result that I knew I wanted. Has that been insane? Yes, but it was worth it. I can't imagine if I would've gave up and just turned my back on this music. Where would I be now? Don't know how I would've made it from underneath that rainy cloud. Had my doubts, yes, but that's how I found my true purpose. If my surface looks great, who cares if underneath I'm hurting? If there's one thing I've learned in my life, it's that life is uncertain. Getting burned is unavoidable, isn't it? Ain't a person alive that hasn't been a victim of being lied to. We're all hypocrites, giving our two cents but not listening. All living in our own world, thinking that we're right when the fact of the matter is a closed mind is the mind of an idiot. Don't believe that's true? Well, open it.
On top of that, she good for me. Maybe one day, even though I got plenty, I still gotta. Got back up, cause it's on. This old train line, I'ma get it done. Got the party jumping like it's double dutch. It was fun to black, they back double up like. I gotta. Yeah, head up, town. But she from the borough. Better known as the boogie down. Oh, so you sucky now. Get up by the kitchen, man. Slippy skin, stuck it to me. And they gotta shut their mouth when they talk it to me. I look around, it's a whole lot of pressure, mama. That has me at the one to come. Hey, peace and love, baby, keep it groovy. Every time we pop out, you know it's a movie. If I'm in hot water, then it's a jacuzzi. I got a shake, so I'm throwing deuces. I got a. I don't want them down back. Yeah, I know how to pop back. Cause you know I got a. She look good, don't she? On top of that, she good for me. Made me wanna say, even though I got plenty, if I'm down to my last penny, I still gotta. Still gotta. You must be knowing here. You see these grown people talking, what you doing here? Put your gear up off the wall, go on, get it moving here. Yeah, I'm just catching the vibe. I told the valley, take your time, it might get a vibe. Floating through the front door, my modest attire. Good mama, you know you're looking divine. I had to turn around, double take, take a little day. Girl, you got good taste, where you could get that? You can mingle with the cool kids. I'm out here sweating like a preacher in a pool pit. Even when I'm down back, I know how to bounce back. I know I got her, and she look good, don't she? On top of that, she good for me. Made me wanna say. And even though I got plenty, if I'm down to my last penny, I still got a. I know I got a. Even when I'm down back, yeah, I know how to bounce back. Cause you know I got a. And she look good,
know she's on top of that, she good for me. Made me wanna say, even though I got plenty, if I'm down to my last penny, I still gotta. Okay, man, I'm telling y'all I'm back. Keep surging the stacks, keep surging and max feels splurging. Living proof what you can have, keep working, okay. Let it turn this way. Things change just like the weather. I got a question for whoever. This little cake of crumbs, sometimes they call me Lucifer. Talk about you do this and that, ain't none of that. She be looking at me like she feeling me. Girl, the way you be moving, the stuff you be doing, you tripping out and it's killing me. Man, I thought I got me be tripping, I can't even do it. My girl, she tryna get me off, no, she cannot do it, no, she cannot do it. Get some sending a gun, he finna get busted. I'm a bitch in my friend, I'm talking about the one that she scratch on. He play, let me get his song, get a crib, but he never gonna rest on. Bitch, fuck, but it ain't for the act, cause I keep me up. Get down, the street boys, cause it's gonna be dead, but you better get your. Talking about, but it's talking, and we get it started. Pull up in the UFO. He ain't seeing us. You follow your pin in that double cup. Wanna step out yourself? Are you good enough? Wanna step out yourself? Are you hood enough? Fire don't kiss, are you pulling up? And now you lay down, ain't no getting up. I'm a tough girl in the bathroom, and it sound like shit. I try that love, ain't getting up. Show to your horsey, I told her they. To stop us, it's myself, the medium, chilling, they gon' pay with the trolls. On a hundred and a high, pray to God we don't lose control. I'ma chase my little whip on.
I'm tripping, this is easy, easy. Meet me, I got numbers, you got CZs, CZs, wake up to it and repeat, repeat.
We
finna get loose. Squeeze up a gavel and give me the juice. Don't wanna just do what it do. Piles of egos can fill up a room. Hop on the flight, take a trip to Peru. Got hop in the way, they're dismissing the roof. My woman flies, look at my money, I'm feeling like a fool. Oh, oh, oh. Pretty much a billion do. Oh, 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 oh. Breaking the hearts and breaking the rules. Oh, 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 oh. 10 out of 10, I'm feeling like 2, 2, 2, 2, 2.
I ain't tripping, this is easy. Easy, God, I'm excited to meet me, meet me. I got feelings, you got CZs, CZs. Wake up to it and repeat, repeat.
I got a mission to get it. On a flight, I didn't finish in Venice. I'm sitting in Venice. Just look at the ticket. I'm traveling, man. I'm switching the pivot. Why would I talk about it when I live it? I know that you live it. I know that you mad. Putting up numbers and flipping the digits again and again and again. When you enjoy the saga. Better pay, give me more of them dollars. Still on the grind, ahead of my time. I yesterday is a yawn and yawners. Trip to Hawaii to bust out the haka. I bust out the haka. I bust out the ooh. When there's nothing to do. Never been capping, you know that it's true, 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 true. Haters are climbing your river like ooh, 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 ooh. Breaking the hearts and breaking the rules, ooh. Oh, oh. 10 out of 10, I'm feeling like 2, 2, 2, 2, 2.
I ain't tripping, this is easy, easy. God, I'm excited to meet me, meet me. I got feelings, you got CZs, CZs. Wake up, get to it and repeat, repeat.
Change, you know, another man made my phone ring hella tapping but won't step, you know, he tell me that's phone hella bling bling black. It's meet and greet. On and off the jet, cause I got places to be. Alright. Business as usual. Usually I wouldn't smile. It's a cost of couple.
Charles and I settled here in the booth. This should be a fun one. Madden Ultimate Team matchup as you get a look at some of the stars here of today's game. Let's get right to it. The ball on the tee, we're set for football, and right, we are underway from Cincinnati. From a yard or two deep, here comes a return. Room to run at the 50. Still going inside the 50.
See, and that's why I always kick the left or the right. But one time I don't, the motherfucker runs it back. But that right there tells me his team has a higher overall than me. That's how it always happens.
Approval from the special teams coach's head coach to bring it out of the end zone.
But let's be honest, a lot of times they bring it out of the end zone like he did there. They don't have approval. I think a lot of times
when I first started Ultimate Team, man, they ran so many fucking kicks back to me. Because I was, you know, like 76 and they were all like 85, 86, 87 at worst.
So now the other return teams out there, as they'll try to duplicate what they just saw.
Nope.
But no run back here. Fair catch, and this will come out to the 25. To throw right away is Vic. Throw left side, caught by the tight end, Njoku. And not much to speak of. Call it a one-yard gain up to the 26.
And he's the epitome of what we call the move tight end, a guy that you can line up anywhere, in the slot, out wide, in tight, doesn't really matter because he has such great skill.
Come on. Jesus Christ. All right. I've done this before. I can't run. He's going to fumble.
It was pretty well blown up from the start, and it results in a turnover.
Yeah, when you're running the option like that as a quarterback, you have so many different keys and reads to make.
This is fun.
That sometimes, as you're making them, you're not protecting the ball the way you should, and it gets popped free.
Up to God, McCaffrey. And he went this near the
How the fuck do you have a run blitz and they still run?
That
wasn't a run blitz.
When he runs, he seems to do a nice job of knowing when to be patient and find the hole, and then when the hole is there, he goes quickly.
You're exactly right. He knows how to just take off, but you know what else? Brings a little thump with him, doesn't he?
He does.
He packs the boom at the end of the run and finishes it going forward. That's what you want to see out of your backs.
And the Bengals are able to strike quickly to end on their lead. Moody good with the extra point.
The score 14-7. A minute in, I'm already losing by 14. I can come back from this. Probably not, but what I do is score and get a stop.
The kicking team out now for the Bengals as they'll send this one away. Here's Christian McCaffrey to return it. And he'll get it up past the 20 to about the 22.
Let's run the old tried and true first.
Buffalo offense ready to go for their next drive. They find themselves in a good size hole here, and a good size hole early on in this game as they come up on first down. He's got this almost to the 40 before going out. That's a good way to start the drive. 17 yards and a first down.
His position, and he's listed as a tight end, but he certainly doesn't run like one. And that's what we're seeing more and more coming into the league. Those guys who can run, make plays after the catch.
Jesus Christ.
And that additional yardage.
And using that speed there to turn it into a pretty nice little game. 2 yards the loss, second and 12. Plays like we just saw there. That's why they're up right now. The defense, they're doing their job.
Yeah, it starts with the guys up front. So when you talk with GMs who are putting together a team, a lot of them say, we're going to build from the inside out. Because if you control the line of scrimmage, you control the rest of the ball game. And that's what we're seeing here. They're actually playing in the offense's backfield, not necessarily just playing at the line of scrimmage.
Only a yard there. Sniffed out well defensively, and it brings up third.
The key to any screenplay is all in the deception. That means everyone on the offensive side of the ball. But someone gave it up because that one wasn't very
Yeah, they gave it up.
And the defense.
Oh, they're talking about the running play.
For just a short game.
There's Vic. This short pass into the hands of Njoku. So the completion good for Simba. And that's going to make it fourth down. They will indeed go for it, Vic.
Oh, come on. Fucking, it's Marvin Harrison, bro.
And they turn it over. So certainly an interesting call there to go for it.
Yeah,
and
the
Vic will force a turnover on downs.
Blah, 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 blah. Blah, blah, blah.
McCaffrey running up the middle. A good job of finding the open space to run as he's getting close to the 30 here. It's a gain of 13, and the Bengals have the first down. Good push up front, and then running between the tackles.
Let's play the leverage game here. Offensive line just got lower than the defensive front, and they're able to get their pads out.
Sit down.
What's coming in down? They goes. That one will set him back nearly 10 yards here on first down on the sack.
I think this defense, Charles, realizing the deficit they're facing, they're going to have to step up and make more plays like we just saw there.
Yeah, and those are the type of plays that can focus a defense because, as we know, they've had their trouble so far in this one. But they just proved to themselves that they can get to it. And I expect them to continue to bring that type of pressure in order to try and turn around their fortunes.
On second down, here's Moon.
He'll get this out right here to McCaffrey.
And he'll lose yardage here. Back at the 41. Just a one-yard loss that time, but that's not what they needed. Now they're dealing with a third and long.
Well, Brandon, we could see that play developing, and they were hoping that he was going to be able to put a move on the first guy and turn it into a big play. But no such luck. The speed on defense continues to get better and better in the NFL. Pretty nice example there of those guys being able to run.
Pressure, and he'll go down. They'll sack him on what ought to be the final play of this first quarter. 14-0 the score. This is the NFL on EA Sports.
Don't go for it. Just punt it. Dude, it's 4-24. He's going.
Here's J.K. Scott set to do the punting honors. And not what he was hoping for there, as this will hit in the end zone for a touchback. The Bills come to the line to start their next drive. Still in the first half, but this offense has struggled. Haven't really been able to get anything going, not only in the points category, but in the yards category.
Yeah, 5 yards. Yay.
And he stopped right at the 25 after a gain of 5.
Not a huge play, but I think they're more than happy with how it turned out. Don't be surprised to see them revisit that call because there was a lane there for more than just 5 yards. Put it in your back pocket and break it out when you need it later.
Able to slow it by. And they're able to get this one across the 35. 12 yards that time, and a Bills first down.
I'm okay with the call there. In fact, I actually like it. I know they're down a couple of scores, but the running game worked in that situation. I would continue to go in that direction.
Vic operating on first down. They'll set up the screen to McCaffrey. Into space at the 45, and all the way up to the 45-yard line. A good pickup there on first as the screen pass gets a made.
And good yardage there on first down because sometimes all you need to do on the screen is get one key block. That might set your man free, and that was pretty good pursuit to the football defensively, or it could have gone for more.
Play action now, Vic. This short pass into the hands of Njoku, and he's got another first down as the tackle's going to be made at the Bengals' 44-yard line. A nice pickup there of 11 yards, and it'll move the sticks.
Second and short, that's a rundown, so it's definitely a good time to go play action if you're feeling it, and they do so and pick up a first down.
This offense finding its legs now. Here's another first and 10. A handoff, McCaffrey running right.
Yeah, that went over.
Just a yard on the first down carry, so it's second and 9. 2 minutes to play, first half, it's 14-0. They work now on second and 9. Throwing, Vic. That ball caught by Harrison. And he's got another first down as the tackle's going to be made at the Bengals' 15-yard line. That's good for 28 yards. This drive, it's been a good mix. 3 passing plays, 3 runs, hitting on all 3 of those passes, and the last one putting him in the red zone.
So wouldn't you think play action right here? Because he's got the ability and had the ability to run it and throw it. Go play action and take your shot at the end zone.
Flag comes in. This might be a free play.
And a quick throw here, that's complete. And he takes it inside the 10 to the 8 before he's out of bounds. And that one was relatively easy to see. I noticed that from up here.
Yeah, it doesn't take a whole lot, does it? Sometimes you get multiples. What I always love on these offsides is when each side points at the other. Hey, you did it. No, you did it. They deciphered that one correctly.
What's an extra? And from the 9, they get this to the 5-yard line.
Looked like the screen pass was taken away there, but what a nice job improvising, finding other options, and completing the pass anyway.
From the 5 now, 2nd and a yard. Now a give, right side McCaffrey. And he'll be brought down right on the edge of the goal line at about the 1-yard line. A 5-yard gain there makes it 1st and goal.
Some good strong running right there. Some power and some explosiveness just about got him into the end zone.
This is 1st and goal and a golden chance to get a score back here before halftime. Vic goes play action. Firing quickly here, that's complete. So we stop for no gain. And make it 2nd and goal.
I know exactly what's going to be said about that play from the defensive perspective.
What's that?
That's why I tell all you guys we need more than one tackler to the ball. He broke the first tackle.
Touchdown! David Njoku, as the first half is winding down. And the Bills are on the board here in the final seconds of the first half. The way this one was going, you just got the sense they needed something before half. They've at least got something on the board now. Still trailing, but a good sign.
That takes me back to our preseason tour of NFL camps. You remember we talked with that one coach who said his emphasis this year was scoring in the last 2 minutes of a half, heading into the locker room. This hits it right there. Take that momentum, take that good feeling, and take the locker room, regroup, and start over. They got it here.
They did indeed. A lot of football, full half to be played. Point after, right down the middle. And that'll make our score 14-7. So not much time to speak of remaining in this first half as the kick's away. And they're going to have really good starting field position here as that's taken it close to the 40. The Bengals drive about to get going. And with 10 seconds left, not really enough time to put something together. Looking for Johnson, and it's intercepted. Goes right side. Inside the
team. Got him.
Thank you very much.
Nickel that time, which we see so often in today's NFL, and there it helped them net their first pick six of the contest.
Nice eyes, good observation there, partner. You nailed it. This is a defense that likes to mix up and disguise coverages, but it didn't to be one of their main packages, the nickel, that fooled them that time, and it made the most of the miscue with a nice return.
Extra point right down the middle, and that will take us to the end of the first half of play. And that'll do it for the end of the second quarter. This is the NFL, and it's on EA Sports. Welcome back. Halftime over. We are ready for quarter number 3 alongside Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gordon. And ready to get the party started for the second half. It was an even first half, all tied on the scoreboard. And the fair catch signaled for and taken, so they'll begin this third quarter from their 25-yard line. Vic will look to throw on first down.
He's got a man. It's his tight end. That's complete. And he gets this up to the 34 out of bounds there. So the completion results there in 9 yards. And that'll give him a short yardage situation here for second down. Out of the pistol.
Ooh, that didn't work.
And this has been a familiar sight all afternoon as they stop it behind the line. Chop that up as a 4-yard loss, and now it's third down.
We all have habits. We can be somewhat predictable, and you know me pretty well on second down and short. What I like to see?
Play action.
Yeah, without a doubt, I thought that's a great spot to call it. Instead, didn't go right away.
I didn't want to go to him. I was trying to go to the deep crosser, but I mean, I can't give up a 3 first down.
At first glance, I thought he just used his size in order to win the route, but he also had a little subtle move in there as well. Made the defender think he was going one direction, but was able to track the ball in another.
And I wasn't supposed to go to him. I actually was supposed to go to Harrison, but I accidentally pressed both buttons at the same time.
If he's that locked in, that means everyone's locked in, because to me it's like throwing a no-hitter in baseball. The pitcher may get the credit, but a lot of people making plays behind him in the field.
So second and 10, third quarter. Thanks for tagging along with us here from the Queen City of Cincinnati. They'll give it up to McCaffrey.
Come on, fucking block, Jesus Christ.
It'll go as a loss of a yard, so now they deal with third and 11. Backed up here, tough spot, needing 11 yards to pick up the first. On third down, Vic.
Ooh, that was bad. Threw it right to him.
And it's intercepted. Hit by Ted Hendricks. And they will be set now as he brings this thing all the way back inside the 20. So from inside the 20, here's first and 10 at the 18. On the counter now with Sanders.
Dude, if you see that I'm in a 3-4, you fucking audible out to a pass.
Officially no gain on the play, and it's second down.
Oh, that was fucking bad. You got four receivers. I have, you'll end up with two linebackers on two fast motherfuckers, and you're going to run them like an idiot.
Second and 10. They'll go again with Sanders. He is going to be stopped cold behind the line of scrimmage. 2 yards the loss, and now third and 12.
Well, that's a tough one right there. He ran right into the teeth of the blitz as the linebacker was freed up in order to stuff that one for a loss. I think quarterbacks got to see that. Got to find a way to audible into something a little more advantageous.
A field goal would get him the lead, but that's not what they're shooting for as they come up on third down. Up the middle they go with Sanders. And he'll only get this to the 17, well shy of what he needed. 3 yards won't be enough here as that'll bring up fourth down. And Jake Moody now on for the field goal. From the left hash, this from 34. And it hits the right.
Fuck. Almost.
But he gets it to go. And they take a 17-14 lead. The kicking team out now for the Bengals as they'll send this one away. And that one.
Yeah. Okay, the servers are down. They don't want no problems. I want no problems. I mean, I guess if it just keeps up, I'm going to have to go get Grand Theft Auto, I guess.
In the bag, cause I've been in my bag, speeding off the tag, yeah.
Hey, well, I don't know what I'm doing, but I don't feel like getting up to get Grand Theft Auto, so, you know, we're gonna just see what we're doing. I don't know what these mini fucking games are. I don't know.
Resets is my joy to be never mentioned. Feeding our children is but in the midges what rappers ain't worth the
mention. I didn't hold the button down.
Thank you.
is quick as heck. Spent most of my days thinking if I would ever live inside the black world. No strength, they had to get me another day, another man down. Look at my shoes, I'm bigger than you. Push me, man, I forget a snack now. The buildings ain't gold, look around where we roam through. In the land of the broken, it's alive, just praying to. Quick as sand was engulfed, cause I'm so. But this patch, I'm evolving, searching for solid food. While most fold, I'm comics composed. After the politics and when no, they vote, it's just froze. I'm off the hip, but the 50s, I can't be part of this system. I pray to God, no, he listen, won't sell my face with some gifts. Keep off my toes. The type of thing to make you consider throwing the time. I'm in the mood to make you go on. I'm showing my sword, declaring the war of foes and cats, yeah. So pass me the torch,
that was bad.
Rockin' like a slipknot. See, this ain't basketball at halftime. We don't switch sides. She thinks she loved me. She fell in love. Side, I got it for less. Fit that, then I got on a check. Hit fast, then we go on a race. Switch it up, with that butter face. Mix it up, got a lot on my plate. Got a broccoli and cheese with a beef on the side. This ain't no regular steak. No one on our way. Richer than me. This ain't up for debate. You gotta love. Payback, layback, map, blast. Just on your truck. Now I'm in the AMG with the all black tint. They don't know it's me, but they got a little hint. How you worry about it? You can't pay rent. Up in the cell at 17. Back in jail with no bail at 19. Up the road with the life at the 20. Made my first 100,000 at 23. Who is he or who is she? But speak on my name and you ain't me. Why do you talking? I'm overseas. Siggy smoke when I move, it was all a dream. Keep on talking and talking and fuck me up. Call me lucky, I guess I got dummy luck. Give it a play, and then it is time. Better believe it, back it up. Hey, get my snitch on YouTube. Say that you was up and flipping on YouTube. Why you always rapping about it? That you do. Why you always rapping about it? That you do.
What you mean you don't know how I'm stepping? What you mean you don't know what I'm rapping? I'm on my hood.
Out the back, where my cat take an L and try to double back. We ain't doing that. Say she mad, but I know it's cap. I've been through with that. Need someone to hype me up. Need someone to hype me up. Hype me up. Need someone to hype me up. Hype me up. Need someone to hype me up. Hype me up. I ain't gotta put the hands to the ceiling. I ain't pumped. In a sprinter. What's that? What's a two of two of?
What the fuck was that? That one was bad.
count this money, then I count my blessings. If I ever took an L, then it's good for lesson. I'm the one, ain't no second guessing. Tried to dim my light, but my soul fluorescent. Wait, I tried to stay, but depressing. I even prayed to God he ain't get the message. I'm living in the present, they gon' feel my presence. You can't dim my light, cause I'm luminescent. I rose from the ashes of the section. I seen a stranger in my own reflection. I point the in my own direction. I would've did it for my own protection.
Oh, okay.
Debating about the goat. I'm the one like 2, 3, 4, 5. How you playing both sides? How I made 1 million, 2 million, multi. How I made 8 figures, 8 million, 4 times. And I was underutilized the whole time it spread. I guess they couldn't find a gold mine, you dig? The sheep sleep on me, but the ghost cosign. I stopped thinking about the future, cause we got no time. The world changed. Damn. The world changed. Yeah, I tried and failed. I see my best friend's jail, but betrayal is the real pain. Damn, the world changed. Look. I built walls around the house, networking. All these bloodsuckers, I just hope it's networking. Soul searching, brokenhearted with my chest hurting. But I was gifted with the best curses. I'm suffocating and my weight keep fluctuating. I show love, how the you hating? Damn, I'm the greatest, but that's unrelated. I either overstate my welcome or I'm underrated. Lately, I've been trying to wake sleepers. The fake woken, the gatekeepers. The shallow for big fish, I stay deeper. We all gotta meet the same reaper and the same maker, even if we never touch the same paper. Made enough for a surplus, quotas, but the money brought us much closer. Used to be silent when they load up. Now they sit around and upload them. I swear the world changed. I swear the world changed. So tell her that you love her, now you can't even remember that girl name. I swear to God the world changed.
Yay, it took me 85,000 tries, but I got gold. Okay. That was bad. I don't like this one.
Corner, we got to stay. Turn the goal up on my hands. Just want another line to my crib. I'm gonna expand on. they ain't think I was gonna blow. They be like, how I make it? Talking like it's been something. It's go time. Let's line it up. I've been rapping something the whole time. I stuck to ground. I ain't gonna no. Need a bitch. Go. Static. I don't need no dramatics. Them boys bigger than plastic. Got time to jump in the bag. Cause I've been in speed talk. Tag.
I can teach you how to get cake. It's not the whole thing. Needs a little slice. Honestly, I'm an immaculate anomaly. My organic organism ain't no ordinary organ genome. I can't afford any synonymy. That's why my flow is like a cinnamon tsunami with the lemongrass. Ooh. Ooh. What you gonna do? If you wanna build, I'm Bobby. Show you how to make a lot of cheese. Got the dialect of Barry in my diary. I'm from a lactose intolerance community. I want to circulate the units and the unity. The continuity of opportunity for stacking bands. Opportunity to stack and bigger with your bandit. I can show you how to get the figures in advance. Don't you nobody else but us can spin a damn.
By draining it. If it's aiming, it's ain't a single thing that can change it. I'm changing it. Get your data straight and circulate. Get the body, body, pop. That thing. If you aim with it, you know when I'm the right. And I don't got to.
This one's fucking hard.
Thank you.
whip. See you, my bitch. It's a freezer. Give me teeth.
Since them days where we raced for 3 days and 4 nights and took them red flights for straight to the plane and through the back of the flight. Then I said,
tripping, this is easy, easy. Meet me. You got CZs, CZs.
Squeeze a big apple and give me the juice. Don't wanna talk, I just do what it do. My alter ego to fill up a room. Hop on the flight to the trip of a room. Yeah, hop in the whip, that dismiss in the room. My woman fired, just look at my boo. I know I'm mighty, I'm gonna ooh, ooh, ooh. Pretty much a billion do. Ooh, 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 ooh. Breaking the hearts and breaking the rules. Ooh, ooh, ooh. 10 out of 10, I'm feeling like 2, 2, 2, 2, 2.
I ain't tripping, this is easy, easy. Got him excited, meet me, meet me. I got niggas, you got CDs, CDs.
To get it. Hop on a flight and finish some business. I'm sitting in the business. Just look at the ticket. The traveling man. I'm switching the pivot. Why would I talk about it when I'm living? Putting up numbers and flipping the digits again and again and again. Enjoy the saga. Better pay, give me more of them dollars. Still on the grind. Ahead of my time. My yesterday's a yawn and yawn. Trip to Hawaii to bust out the haka. I bust out the haka. I bust out the ooh. When it's nothing to do. Never been capping. You know it's true, 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 true. Haters are climbing your river like ooh, 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 ooh. Breaking their hearts and picking their boots. Ooh, ooh. 10 out of 10, I'm feeling like 2, 2, 2, 2, 2.
I ain't tripping, this is easy, easy. Got him excited, meet me, meet me. I got diamonds, you got CZs, CZs. Wake up, get to it and repeat, repeat.
I gotta warn you, yo, man, we ain't even scratched the surface. The black
been okay. Man, I'm telling y'all, I'm back. Keep urging the stacks. Keep surging and max feel splurging. Living proof what you can have. Keep working, okay? Better turn this away. Things change just like your brother. Yeah. I got a question for whoever. Yeah, this little Kega call, sometimes they call me Lucifer. Talk about you do this and that, ain't none of that. Tell me.
I guess we're gonna have to reboot the computer or the PlayStation, whatever. My dog wants attention, so I guess I better give her some attention. Aaron, what's pretty girls doing? Come here. Oh, you got eye boogies, baby. That's good girls, it sure is. It's in the game. Hey Aaron, did you know it's in the game? Okay, I guess I just needed to reboot my the whole time. Okay, maybe not.
You see these grown people talking, what you doing here? I gotta have a mind to hit you with a gun. Put your get up off the wall, go on, get it moving here.
I'm just catching the vibe. I told the valet, take your time, it might get a vibe. Flowing through the front door, my modest attire. Good Lord, mama, you know you look at the fine. I had to turn around, double take, take a look at that. Girl, you got good taste, where you cook it at? You can mingle with the cool kids. I'm out here sweating like a preacher in a pulpit. Even when I'm down bad, I know how to bounce back. I know I got it. And she look good, don't she?
Okay, all right, here we go.
Made me want to say,
we're back.
Know I got plenty. If I'm down to my last penny, I still got it. I know I got it. Even when I'm down bad, I know how to bounce back. Because you know I got it. She look good, don't she? On top of that, she good for me. Made me want to say, even though I got plenty, if I'm down to my last penny, I still got a.
We are set, ready to rock for this Madden Ultimate Team matchup. And these guys on your screen, ready to rock as well. Some of the stars of today's game. And speaking of the game, let's get right to it. And we are underway in Buffalo. And here comes a return from just beyond.
Why am I wearing the Texans uniform?
To bring it out, not a good one, as he's tackled at the 15.
Oh, okay, well, I guess I'm a Texan now. Or an Oiler, whatever. Those uniforms are dope as fuck.
To throw right away is Vic. Got an open man. That's David Njoku, the tight end. It's near the 30. In fact, right on the 30. A good start offensively. 15 yards on the game's initial play. So first and 10 now from the 30. They just get the playoffs. Now Vic. Throw out wide is incomplete. He was trying to get it to his tight end, David Njoku. That'll bring up second down. First carry of the game for Christian McCaffrey.
At least he fell forward for 3 yards. I'll take that.
And guess what? That brings up third down. Pretty good little two-play sequence there. You force the incompletion, then a very short pickup.
Yeah, now maybe you bring in an extra defensive back or two because you want to try and defend on third down. They like to play those nickel or sub packages, don't they?
So 7 yards from the first down here as they come up to the line of scrimmage. On third down, Vic. Able to find the open man. That's complete. And he will have the Titans first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
He's a combination of elite arm strength and obviously the ability to move the sticks with that completion. But it's the way that he throws the ball. So compact, yet the ball comes off of his hand and it just whistles to the receiver.
Apparently, I just ran right into fucking
second down.
I feel like I could see what he was thinking on that carry. Wanted to follow that big tackle through the hole. Ended up only getting 4 yards on the carry. I think he had designs on that one being bigger.
Second down at 6 now. Now Vic running the option left.
Jesus Christ.
And one of the linemen on the other side has got it. So that play, I mean, it was pretty well blown up from the start, and it results in a turnover.
Yeah, when you're running the option like that as a quarterback, you have so many different keys and reads to make that sometimes as you're making them, you're not protecting the ball the way you should, and it gets popped free.
So good field position for the Bills as they come up first and 10 right at the 50-yard line. From the gun, it's a run for Williams. And he'll manage to pick up about four. It's second down.
Nice chunk of yards on first down. It really opens up your options for what you want to do on second. You go right back to him and hope he explodes or sucker the defense in before throwing over the top.
Williams going to get it again on second down. And he is going to get this close to the first down markers. He's brought down at the Titans 42.
A quick burst there, and he nicely bit off a pretty decent game.
So third and two, this quite possibly four down territory, though, if they're stopped. To throw, Vic. It's a screen to Ricky Williams. And he's going to get this inside the 30. It's a gain of 13 and a Buffalo first down.
But Charles, it's early, but that's a key third down conversion. Remember, they forced the turnover on the opening drive. Now they're in a position where they look like they'll at least get three out of this.
A great example of complimentary football for able to cash this in, isn't it, partner? Because defense does its job, takes it away, turns over the offense. Here's pick up a nice first down there. Maybe it's time to think about taking a shot at the end zone because it looks like the field goal is almost assured.
Pick up their 26 yards.
I think when they look at their offense, they think to themselves, weapons everywhere. They want to move the ball around. They want to spread it to different people. But you absolutely know they want to get this man involved as well. And that's what they just did on that play.
Vic. This is Bills touchdown. From 3 yards over. And the Bills have taken the early lead on the road here in Buffalo. For the extra point, Cameron Dicker. And it's 7-0.
Dicker, hardly know her.
The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. This fielded right at the goal line. And able to take it past the 25 and up to the 28-yard line. The Titans offense set to begin the drive. They had the fumble on the last drive, wound up leading to the opening touchdown. Now they'll try again here, first and 10. They'll get a yard, that's all, as they get him down at the 28.
No doubt about it. A really nice job there by the defense, not allowing him to get to the perimeter. But that means your defensive ends, your outside linebackers, the guys that you pay big money to set the quarterback. They also have to have interest in the running game as well. And they did a nice job there holding the point of attack and not giving ground.
After 1-7-0, on EA Sports. Second quarter now, Titans in possession of the football as they've got it with a first and 10. Out of the pistol, McCaffrey. He's got it to the 43 here.
Not a run that you're going to write home about, but still, good first down run. That's what an offense calls staying on schedule. 3 to 4 yards on first down, you're set up very well for the rest of the drive.
From the 43, here's second and 6. Now here's Vic. They'll set up the screen to McCaffrey. Room with a move here at the 45. All the way down to the 33-yard line. 9 yards to pick up there, and it's a first down.
The defense was ready for the back to leak out and even had a second player waiting to double him up. If you're going to commit to doubling the back, you better prevent a completion, but give him credit. Extra determination, extra effort, turn it into a successful play.
and just no chance of turning the corner. He can only get back to the line of scrimmage. Second and 10 coming up.
The running lanes have definitely not been there for him here in the first half, and I don't think it's all been his fault. His offensive line hasn't given him much space. A loss results there.
Now a second and 10. Vic now. This is the tight end, Njoku. And he is out of bounds inside the 30. So the completion good for 7 there. And now that sets up 3rd and 2. That's a staple of this offense. Drag route to the tight end.
Yeah, he's unable to use his size to break off much more yardage after the catch, but still an effective gain nonetheless.
Trying to keep the drive going here. This is play number 7 on 3rd and 2. From the gun, Vic. There's a short one from Uzama. And he will have a 10's first down. They needed 3. He doubled that. He got 6. Gotta say, I was a little surprised to see him, Charles, come out in the shotgun on 3rd and less than a yard.
Yeah, but the way the NFL is nowadays, we've hardly ever seen anyone really run for it on short yardage. So they're going to throw the football more times than not. That's a nice, easy rhythm throw right there. And they pick up the first ball.
Got him.
Tennessee touchdown. Christian McCaffrey taking it from the 20. And the Titans are an extra point away now from tying this ball game. Now the try here for the extra point. It's up and good. We're tied at 7 here in quarter number 2. So I'll leave it at 7 now as they kick it away. And he's going to get this across the 20 as he's out of bounds at the 23. Buffalo offense ready to go for their next drive. This drive here beginning probably with a pair of motivated groups. Remember, the offense scored a touchdown on their last time out, looking to repeat that in Charles' defense. They were very frustrated after giving up 6 the last time on the field.
And frankly, it's just a battle of wills in a lot of ways, because you know they're both motivated, they both game plan for this drive, and they both have specific outcomes in mind. To me, it just comes down to who can execute better and which side can step up and assert its will over the other.
All the way up at the 38 down after a good start to the drive. There's Michael Vick.
Sit down.
Complete to Fetterman. They'll give him 4 yards there, and that will bring up 2nd down. There's Vick. Dancing to his left. Pass incomplete, but the flag in the backfield, and this might be a roughing call.
That was me.
Sometimes we talk about the lengths officials sometimes go to protect star quarterbacks, but that one, that was tough to argue against.
Yeah, and I'm sure that everyone's going to say, hey, we're going to administer the penalty the same way for all quarterbacks. But when it's a star back there, even more so are they going to be diligent about throwing the flag.
A first down throw coming from Vic. They'll set up the screen. This is Williams. This will be stopped about 2 yards shy of the marker. 8-yard gain, 2nd and 2. They'll throw again. Here's Vic. And a big loss here as he's taken down. The defense rising to the challenge and sending him back on the sand.
Okay, I'm not sure you could actually draw a better pass rush than that one right there. Nowhere to go outside. He had to keep backing up and backing up and backing up. Eventually dropped for a huge loss.
Vic now for the 50. Screen play set up for Williams. The Titans going to use the first of their timeouts as they stop it with 28 seconds to go in the first half of play. It looked like the defense, they were ready for that one.
Really left him almost no room to work after catching the ball. He could throw every move in the book at him. They were there, and they tackled him for a loss.
On fourth down, the punt team is on as this is sent away. And that one hits a little too close to the goal line, and it continues into the end zone for a touchback. Tennessee offense about set and ready to go. Now the ball backed way up, so thinking with this amount of time on the clock, probably just sit on it, and we'll see these two teams go to the lockers.
Yeah, I don't think you want to overthink it in this situation. Either side of the ball, just go ahead and finish up the half and get on out and talk about it.
The corner blitz worked to perfection there for Deion Sanders. So two quarters down, two remain. Charles and I return after the break. And we welcome you back now alongside Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gunn, getting set for quarter number three here. Set and ready to go for the second half. One touchdown apiece, 7-7 our score.
Siéntate, siéntate.
The Bills come to the line to start their next drive. Well, the first half, very even. I mean, really, in all facets, this ball game tied, Charles, so as we start the third quarter. Curious to see what the second half brings us.
Certainly am. I'm with you on that one. And we all know the coaches from the NFL all the way down to the peewee level. They love to spin it to their teams. Hey, we're starting a brand new shorter ball game. It's all even. Let's go out and seize it. This is ours.
Vic's throw complete there to Johnson. And he takes this up to the 40-yard line before being corralled. He was held without a catch in the first half, but he's got one here. He also picks up a first down.
An ex-teammate used to tell me all the time, I hate experienced quarterbacks because no matter what, you really can't hide what you're doing. And I think that right there, he knew right away where the blitz was coming from, where his primary guy was going to be, and he ended up going to a secondary target for a nice game.
I was just going to ask you, that wasn't the primary target, and he's so good at that, isn't he?
I think he knew right away that he wasn't going to get to his primary guy. I think he read that as soon as he got to the line of scrimmage, knew where the pressure was going to come from, and said, I know how to beat that, and that's what he did.
Well, just shy of midfield, here's second down and one. Throwing, Vic. Throw here, taken in by Riley, the tight end. And he's going to have another first down as the tackle's made at the Titans 35. A new set of downs after a strong pickup of 16 yards. So operating from Tennessee territory now. Here's first and 10 at the 35-yard line. And Vic's throw there, incomplete.
And their back's up against the wall a little bit, and they come through by forcing an incompletion. Now they've got to continue to ratchet up the intensity a couple of more times and get off the field before giving up any more yardage.
On second down, Williams. And this will be a gain of 5 as he gets it to the 30. Looking to speed things up here, going with some tempo. Vic readies to throw. Trying to get it to Williams, but it's intercepted.
Thank you very much.
You're trying to take the lead in this third quarter, but then one mistake, and you're watching the ball being returned for a touchdown.
Certainly a great example of how focus has to be there on every play, doesn't it, partner? You can't get complacent, and I think that he did. He's got him moving downfield, but that's a play where he just shouldn't have thrown the football. And ultimately, could wind up costing the ball game.
Point after, right down the middle, and that makes the score 14-7. To So they throw the pick six. They'll get another shot at it now as this one's in the air. And he'll be out of bounds here. A yard shy of the 25 of the 24. Buffalo offense ready to go for their next drive. Now remember, they were just out here a moment ago through the pick six, so we'll see if they can take better care of the football this go around.
Yeah, and sometimes I think it's almost better that you just throw the pick six and you come right back out on the field. You're not over on the sidelines dwelling for very long. You're not hearing everyone say, hey, you'll get them next time. Hey, don't worry about it. Allen tries to force it to Megatron, and it's intercepted.
Man, how you gonna quit? Oh, I guess you throw two pick sixes in a row and you decide you're gonna be a little bitch and fucking quit. If you're gonna be a bitch, don't play Madden. How many times I got my ass whooped by 28 points? I don't fucking quit. I mean, like in the fourth quarter, there's definitely no chance to come back. But dude, you're down two scores.
Charles Davis, as always, I'm Brandon Gaudin. Charles, you talk about storylines in this one. I think it begins and ends with our two quarterbacks, certainly two of the best in the business.
It's sad that my best players are fucking linebackers.
Long periods of time without a top-flight quarterback, the way the game is played, with all the responsibility he has and how the game flows through him, if he's not on the top of his game, your team's not going to benefit at all.
And we are underway in Buffalo. This taken in at the goal line. And he's up across the 25 and down at the 28. The drive begins with a run by McCaffrey. And pass the four.
Can't fumble it, running out of bounds.
Give them 15 yards to start their first drive of the game. Well, there you go. This offense off to a strong start this afternoon.
Yeah, with a big run and a first down. That's putting what you practice into play. That's excellent execution to get things started.
And a good burst there gets him seven up to midfield. Absolutely no trouble moving the ball on the ground on the first two plays from scrimmage.
Absolutely. You know what I really like? Same guy carrying the ball in both plays. And what drives me crazy is when a back has a nice run, he taps his helmet to go out of the game. I would want the ball again and again and again because you've established really nice momentum, and now you're seeing the field really well.
This will be a loss of three, and now a much tougher third down looming. They are in need of 6 yards here if they hope to move the chains. Vic to throw it. This short pass into the hands of Njoku. And he's got a first down as a tackle made at the Bills' 41-yard line. The drive stays intact with a pickup of 13.
Well, a lot of times when you get a manageable third down situation like this, you have to think about your tight end, and he comes through for him, picking up the first down.
Blitz coming.
Damn, nobody fucking blocked a soul on that. Holy fuck.
They
didn't even
defensively on the previous play, they gave
it was like, nah, bro, we good. We ain't gonna block
right back.
And if we just flip it around from the offensive perspective, took a nice step forward, and how about a couple of leaps backwards after that play? They've got to figure out a big call coming up here to try and gain that yard.
Oh, you're so lucky that was incomplete.
Second down from Vic, incomplete.
I can assure you, setting up a screen is much more difficult than it appears. It requires excellent timing from everyone on the offense, and a defense's number one goal is to throw that timing off.
Now on third and long, they'll look to throw. And they take him down. The Bills get to him. Shaq Thompson gets in there to
I'm gonna go for it on 4th and 32. I got you right here, buddy. I'm going for it. Oh yeah. Oh.
Here's Ryan Stonehouse now. As the first drive of the game stalls out, he's on to punt. And no one there to stop it. Hits at the 8, but it carries all the way into the end zone for a touchback. Allen and the Bills now with a 1st and 10 at their own 20-yard line. Throwing to start the drive. Allen, throw complete right side to Cooks. And he's taken down, but able to slip across the 35. The catch and run there, good for 16 and a first.
Of course, the catch was nice, but how about what happened after? Able to stay on his feet and gain all that additional yardage. So many of these slot guys, I think, have running back in their background.
Allen now on first down. The left side caught by Diggs. And he slips up past the 45 before being tackled. 11 yards and a Buffalo first down.
I don't care who you put on him, he's going to be a handful in one-on-one throws.
Yeah, right now, you're right. They're in man-to-man, maybe need some safety help.
I would say that'd be a good idea. Double team him somehow. I'm going to have to make someone else beat me rather than let him shred my defense.
Back-to-back good plays have him on the move on first down. Here's Allen to throw it. Flushed out right. He'll find Diggs once more on the completion. And that'll be good for 8 yards to the 45. 2 yards to go, second down. Throwing now is Allen.
Oof.
That one into the hands.
Man, he could have been more open if he tried. Jesus Christ.
Touchdown. DeAndre Hopkins, 45. And the Bills have taken the early lead on the road here in Buffalo. And his kick is no good. An inauspicious start here kicking-wise as this one stays a 6-0 game. Now he's back out there to boom this one away, maybe with some frustration after the PAT miss. From a couple yards deep, he'll bring it out of the end zone. And ultimately, he stopped right where he would have been if he had simply gone down to a knee at the 25. And this will probably be the last play of the quarter. They start on the ground with McCaffrey. Six nothing, our score
was
after
horrible.
One.
Ah.
Second quarter now, Titans in possession of the football as they've got it facing a second and long situation. Looking to throw, Vic. This ball tipped, and it's going to be incomplete. Fortunate maybe to get that back. It's third down.
I like the call. It looked like the right time to dial up a running back screen, but this one got disrupted right from the start and ends up falling incomplete.
Third and long for Vic. And that's going to be incomplete.
Two drives.
I got to focus on my offensive line. They are just getting beat, 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 beat.
This offense to get on track in this one.
Fourth down, Ryan Stonehouse on to punt. Taken from just outside the 30.
It's all that running
subtract 8 yards there for the return. And the Bills will take over the football with a 1st and 10. The Bills come to the line to start their next drive. We have to be thrilled with that first drive that got him the touchdown. Now they'll be looking to make it a two-score advantage here on the road.
And you know, they spent all week in practice, in meetings, talking about taking an early advantage. Being the road team, going up a score, that takes the crowd out of the game and puts some doubt in the minds of their opponents. Well, that was an interesting look there, because as soon as he got outside the pocket, I thought he was going to take off and run for yardage. But what often happens now with these quarterbacks who can move, defenses want to try and keep bodies in front of them.
Oh, into a sea of defenders and intercepted. Now inside the 25. And they will finally get him to Madden until he's all the way down inside the 15-yard line.
Oh, timing is everything on a route like this. He tried to drive that football into a tight spot. And if you're a little early or a little late, chances are there's going to be someone there. And sure enough, this one's going the other way.
From down at the 12, it's first and 10. So here's Vic following the interception.
Come on.
And he's wrapped up, taken down, back at the 25. The former third overall pick, Quinnen Williams, there to bring him down. And he continues, Charles, to be under constant pressure, and these sacks, they're starting to pile up.
If they want to have a realistic chance in this one, they've got to change their blocking assignments. They've got to do a better job to keep him upright. If he's going to be on the deck constantly, they've got no chance to win this game.
And he is out of bounds right around the 10-yard line. It'll be a pickup of 15, as that'll lead to third down.
His position, and he's listed as a tight end, but he certainly doesn't run like one. And that's what we're seeing more and more coming into the league. Those guys who can run, make plays after the catch, and gain that additional yardage.
And using that speed there to turn. It's taken for a Titans touchdown. Devontae Smith from 10 yards out. And the Titans,
I feel a little better about my shitty offensive face.
Moving out in front. Extra point attempt to come here. He's got it, and they take the lead at 7-6. There's the Titan kick team as they run up and send this one away. And out a little across the 25 to the 27. Buffalo offense ready to go for their next drive. And we'll see if they can bounce back from that last drive. In particular, if they can bounce back at the quarterback position, Charles, after throwing their first interception of the ball game.
Yeah, some guys, you know, they're going to want to try and get a big play right away and take control back. Others, they're going to look to hit a couple shorter passes, get a little momentum back that way.
But for the defense, the goal's not changing a bit. They want another pick.
You're exactly right about that. In fact, you got to watch them a little bit, because in coverage, they may cut down their gaps a little bit, maybe their splits a little bit, in order to try and get to the ball even faster.
First catch for him on the afternoon, and it results in a first down. Now Allen. Over the middle, and there's a diving catch. And he has a big gain inside the 40 before being dropped. 23 yards on the play.
I'd have to say that whenever you see a good post route run, they do not like to let it end without the catch. Hence, that great diving play.
Yeah, lay it up there, let him go get it, and he got it. Here's Allen on first and 10. And his throw here is incomplete.
And not a common sight, at least on this drive. A momentary setback, though, for this passing game that has been moving well this series. Good thing for them, though. Still two more downs to connect and try to pick up another first down.
Second and 10. Allen.
Dude, you threw it right to me. He didn't even try. What the fuck was that?
Picked up by Javon Holland. And the Titans are going to have it here at their own 32-yard line. The Titans offense set to begin the drive. Still more than a minute to go, so you know, there is time if they want to mount something here.
Not only time, but they have three timeouts at their disposal as well. So that changes everything that you're doing here. Without those timeouts, you can only work the sidelines hoping to get out of bounds. Here, the middle of the field is still available because you can call timeout and regroup.
Vic operating on first down. Oof. And he slings one that's incomplete.
NFL quarterbacks work so hard on their mechanics, and they do so much repetition and practice, off-season, the whole deal. They expect it to be autopilot once the game starts. That way it eliminates any type of pressure of the game, pressure of people in your face, all of that.
Come on. Will you guys fucking block somebody? Jesus Christ.
Sacks for him here in this first half. So that now four first-half sacks. This pass rush has been unrelenting.
And partner, you hear that sound of paper being ripped to shreds? That's a game plan that they've had so far because they've got to say to themselves right now, we have to do something differently.
Now third down and very long. Working out of the gun, Michael Vick. Oh, the ball comes out on the hit, but they'll say it's incomplete.
One first down here, and that's all, folks. Good work by this defense to hold things in check and force a punting situation.
Here's Ryan Stonehouse now as he's on to punt for Tennessee. He's been a busy man here in this first half as he gets it away. This is taken at about the 14. A big kick, 50 yards that time with a return of four. And it will be first and 10 as they take over. The Bills come to the line to start their next drive. A slim deficit here in a one-possession game. Not much time left, obviously. We'll see if they can march this down the field, at least get three, and take some momentum into the locker room. Now the Bills will use the second of their timeouts as they'll stop it with just over 40 seconds to go in the first half. So first and 10 now from the 30. To the air, Allen. That swung out wide to Harris. That's good. The completion there for 7 yards, and it's second down. Allen trying to hurry everybody up to the line of scrimmage. On second down, here's Allen. It's complete to Diggs. And he'll go out of bounds, it appears, right at the 45. Allen to Diggs there for a Buffalo first. They like going to him in the slot. He catches another one.
I think this comes under the heading of, until they stop him, why not go back to him? He had something going really well. Great working relationship with the guy throwing the ball, and they keep making the connection.
And this is incomplete. Oh, he looked like he had a pretty good line on that one. Well, that would have been a big play, but he could not pull it in.
And that is not what you expect from a receiver of his caliber. Sometimes you get a little ahead of yourself, you don't look it in, and all of a sudden it's on the ground. A surprise to all.
That's complete. It's Travis Kelce. And offensively, they'll take the timeout with 6 seconds left in the second quarter. So even though it's first down, here's the field goal unit on now to try to get three before halftime. From the right hash, this from 53. And this won't get there. Won't be online either. It's no good. Off to the right, and that'll keep this a one-point game.
Boy, that could have been a real momentum boost going into the break. You get into field goal position with a chance to seize the lead, but this one doesn't find the target, and they're unable to capitalize.
Tennessee offense about set and ready to go. And they'll have time for one play. It's 2 seconds on the clock. And he's going to go there. Couldn't get a throw off with the pressure. Maybe that was for the best, as that brings us to the end of his first half of play. So a very tight first half. We had to break in a one-point game. As we'll head down to Orlando, that's where we find our man Jonathan Coachman at our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach, welcome back. Charles and I settled into the booth ready for quarter number three. The Bills trail here, but they will get the football first as we are back underway on EA Sports.
And a good run back.
Field position. He'll get this one all the way up to about the 35-yard line. Buffalo offense ready to go for their next drive. Charles, it'll be interesting to see what adjustments this offense made in the locker room. Haven't really been able to get anything going offensively, virtually nothing in the ground attack either. So certainly something has to change here in quarter three.
And I'm pretty sure their friends from the defensive side of the ball told them exactly that, because those guys, the stop troops, they've been playing pretty well. They've kept them around in this game. Now they got some time. The running game struggled in the first half. Opposition knows how to focus on defending the pass here. They've got to re-energize that ground game and maybe open things up for a comeback here in this half.
So the big play changes the complexion of things. Here's first and 10 just outside the 30. And this is caught. It's Jimmy Graham. Give him a gain of 5 on the completion, and it'll be second down.
Nice rhythm throw there on first down. He located his tight end, made a nice easy pitch and catch.
Hoping he can break a tackle or two. Wasn't able to do that there, but still good yardage. From the 28, it's second and 5. Allen now looks to throw. Escaping the pressure right. They'll wind up with positive yardage. It's a gain of 3, but now it's third down. And the offense moving quickly to the line. Now at 3rd and 2, they're going to elect to throw with Allen. He's going to get that to his running back out of the backfield. And he is going to have the Bills first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
It's taking a while for this offense to get going. A little creaky at the start, but they're oiled up now. A nice throw there, and they're really putting together a good drive.
On first down, Allen. And he's going to be intercepted for the third time thus far. Picked up by Javon Holland.
Brandon, we spent time with this team before the game, and there was never any indication that they did not like their kicker.
Well, it shows right now that they didn't like their kicker. Why didn't they just put it through the goalposts and take the lead?
That is going to be the question that has to be answered. I don't know about you, but I'm skipping my flight. I'm going to the post-game press conference to find out what they were thinking.
Instead of playing conservative, they go through the air, and what a stunning turn of events. Extra point right down the middle, and the lead is up to 8. So they'll get another shot on offense following that pick 6, and now the kick is away. And he'll be stopped up at the 25. The Bills come to the line to start their next drive. And, Charles, they're certainly still right in this game, but they need that offense to wake up and in a hurry.
Yeah, I like the way you put it. They certainly did seem to sleepwalk a bit in the first half. Now that their defense has done its job, it's their turn now to go out and try to get some points.
On play action, Allen. And the Titan defense steps up here, and down he goes. And they're going to hurry back to the line now. Here's Allen. And that is incomplete. A lot of force bearing down on him there. He could not hang on. It's third down. We saw this a lot in the first half, and it continues. These receivers just not able to get much separation.
So that means they have to win the 50-50 balls. They've got to go up with the defender and find a way to start coming down with them.
And this time, contact and another incomplete pass. On 3rd and long, it's Allen. Throw left side is complete on the diving effort. And they will get this across midfield, but still well short of the first as he's dropped at the 46. So they're going for it, and here's Allen. And
got him.
And they turn it over. The Bills drive stalls out on 4th down. And as a result, it'll be Titan football on the turnover on downs.
The Titans offense set to begin the drive. On first down, this is McCaffrey. And he is met in his tracks behind the line of scrimmage. No big surprise, Micah Parsons doing what he does so well, dropping it for a loss.
Sometimes you just sit back and marvel at what he can do defensively. Speed, strength, quickness, he's the whole package. And that package just wrapped up the runner for a loss.
And that is going to do it for this third quarter of action. You are watching Madden Ultimate Team on EA Sports. Back now in Buffalo. It's the Titans. They've got the football. They'll be looking to extend their lead here as we begin the fourth quarter. First play of the drive goes the wrong way. Here's second and 12. From the shotgun, it's Vic. This short pass into the hands of Njoku. But he takes this one down almost all the way to the third.
Don't quit. Damn.
Like I'm here to snatch their children. That line was brilliant. How I'm not already in the millions. Am I not the picture of resilience? Why they test my patience? Keeping all this blank. Someone gotta bring it, just be liking all the same. This is what in the street game. I'm convinced that nobody is speaking my language. I'm a city as so listen close when I say this. I can make a thing go. Everything I wrote gon' smoke so dangerous. I can make an Einstein feel brainless, but look on the bright side, hope you'll change it. I'ma get it started.
making me a party. This is the type of beat that keep the whole crowd marching. Time to shut it down, we made the whole town sparking. From out of space, so all my homegirls marching. It's about to get critical. This moment is pivotal. Here to feed the streets that say my influence, I'm pitiful. We gon' make it grimy. This will get behind me. Told you I'm the best. I done said it with my chest. So for real, nobody try. For the money and two for the love. We the new era, so whoever may feel they above. Living illusion, it's an illusion, it's absent. Keep it together, don't act like you didn't know what it was. Come on, a whole other planet, I'm about to show you. Wouldn't work if we planned it, meaning you won't understand it. We have to win like a fighter, this feel like Clinton and Adam. We got involved with the pattern, so now we up in the atom. Watch out for my evolution. Evolution, I am more than a being, I'm an institution. If I gotta reiterate, that's where I'ma lose it. And I'm generous and that job will lose it. I'm obnoxious, he ain't got a conscience. He's okay with being a little absurd and pompous. That's because I kill it and stick around just to haunt it. And on my thank you, be grateful that I would even if she watches. For a second, look at your neighbor and check it. We about to mock, so if you not get to step it, I done told you who I am. I'm a force to be reckoned with. I think you just be mad because my voice is so decadent. I'm setting the precedent, no mistakes and no accident. We ignore and understand the seconds. Our lowest is passionate. It's a low, it's a classic hit. I'm a verb amongst adjectives. If the industry put in my words, it's a laxative. I'm a maniac.
And I'm telling y'all, I'm back to beat. And the stacks keep surging, and max feels flirting. Living proof what you can have, keep working. Things change just like the weather. Big question for who?
With Charles Davis, as always, I'm Brandon Gaudin. Charles, you talk about storylines in this one. I think it begins and ends with our two quarterbacks, certainly two of the best in the business.
And nowadays, I don't think you can get by for long periods of time without a top-flight quarterback. The way the game is played, with all the responsibility he has and how the game flows through him, If he's not on the top of his game, your team's not going to benefit at all.
And we are underway in Buffalo. But no run back here. Fair catch, and this will come out to the 25. On play action, Vic.
Throw on the right side, complete to Harrison.
And this will be a gain of 5 as he gets it to the 30. Ball on the 30, they'll come up with a 2nd and 5. Throwing, Vic. And he's got his target, it's Vernon Davis. Well, here he is, but able to get it up past the 45. 17 yards on that play for the Titans. First carry for Christian McCaffrey. And he's able to take it across midfield before going out of bounds. Give him 5 on the carry there, and it'll be 2nd down.
Now that's exactly what you want on a 1st down run. Pick up 5 yards, bring up 2nd and 5. The defensive line, though, they've got to figure out a way to leverage the guys up front because the offensive line is winning at the point of attack.
5 yards on 1st down, but now just a 1 yard pickup there on 2nd.
One advance having a lead guy in the middle of the defensive line because not only does he take up the space and let the linebackers run free, but he can also make plays himself, as we just saw there.
Third and 4. Vic to throw it. There's a short one coming from his head, but they won't get close. Only a yard, 4th and 3.
Excellent job there defensively. Gave up the underneath to the tight end on 3rd down, and they made sure that they did their job. Got them on the ground and prevented them picking up a 1st down.
Pass taken in. It's good tight end. And he gets it inside the 30. Just shy of the 30. Them getting a 15. And keeping the drive alive. Charles, their first drive of the game, and already they're taking chances here, but they get the 4th down conversion. I'm curious, do you think that that's something they game plan for on the opening drive if it came up, or is that something that happened organically?
I think that they game plan for it, Brandon. And when you think about it, let's just say it. The word analytics is a big part of how everyone looks at a game nowadays, but it's not just the analytics. It's a coach willing to be daring, willing to be bold, and they certainly were there.
Ball on the 28-yard line. Here's 2nd and 6. It's a play fake. Now Vic to the left side and complete for Amari Cooper. And they're going to have another 1st down as the tackle's made at the Giants 16. 12 yards there as they move the chains. So the ball down to the 16 here for 1st and 10. Up the gut, McCaffrey. And he will score. Touchdown.
Got him.
Christian McCaffrey, a 16-yard touchdown run. And the Titans get the upper hand as they're on the board first here this afternoon. And that caps off what was really a balanced opening drive for them, Charles. They work in the rushing game and the aerial attack, and they end it with a touchdown.
Strong in so many ways, rushing partner, their ability to throw it and run it and accomplish their goal, they've got to like the way that they started this ball game.
The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. And able to get this out to the 25. Vic will look to throw on 1st down. That's complete. It's Kyle Juszczyk.
And they were able to break one tackle, but they quickly brought down. What a nice little game.
And as a quarterback, you're always pleased when you can use all the weapons at your disposal. Here he spots his fullback underneath, gets the completion right there for a nice pickup.
There's Michael Vick. They'll get this out to Kamara. And he'll be bounds up near the 45 at the 44. That would a first down pickup of 8. Let's see what kind of mindset they have here offensively after giving up a touchdown on the opening drive.
And based on our time with them, you know, prior to this game, I feel like they've got a good mindset going in. In fact, the discussion that we had with the coaching staff was, you know, we may give up some points in this game, so offense has to be ready each and every time, either equal or try to get us ahead and try to keep us ahead. This is their chance to respond to that first touchdown game.
After 1-7-0 on EA Sports. So operating from Tennessee territory now. Here's first and 10, right at the 40. They'll throw again. Here's Vic. That's caught by the Hall of Famer, Marvin Harrison. And brought down the night before they're inside the 25. Another strong gain on the last two plays. They've moved it a combined 33 yards. And forget about the run to set up the pass. They're just coming out throwing.
Forget trying to set anything up. They feel like they have the advantage. They feel like they have the matchups, and they're just attacking right now.
Yep, going to the air on the opening drive. We'll throw over the middle, take it in. And it's going to get a solid gain of 9 before being brought down. Second and right at a yard. So 5 plays on this drive, Charles. All passes are completions. And just like that, they're in the red zone.
And don't you think the playbook opens up a little bit more now? Because all they've done is throw the football. If you want to run it now, you may very well have them fooled.
Second down in the yard. It'll be Vic once more. And a heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. We thought this defense would be opportunistic, and they were. Here you are. Now you got a 2-touchdown lead. I tell you, going out there on defense, did they have a little bit of extra momentum with a score already on the board?
Oh, without a doubt. That already felt good to them. They took it and used it and obviously put up another one. But here's the thing now. Some defense coordinators might want to pull their guys back a little bit because they don't want them to make mistakes because they're too overamped. Others say, I got 2-touchdown lead. Go get them, guys. They'll be even more aggressive.
So they throw the pick 6. They'll get another shot at it now as this one's in the air. And some good special teams coverage as they bring him down just outside.
Wasn't good special teams coverage. That was me getting lucky.
The Giants offense at the line, ready to begin their next drive. And they're in a bind early here, down 14-0. Are you working on everything for the
point? He's quitting. Why is it every time I do well, they quit? Okay, all right, GH, I guess you can stop edging yourself. I hate to upset you. I know you were really looking forward to a little shaking hands with the boss man, but, you know, them's the breaks.
Thank you very much.
All right, let's see how we can do now.
rhymes are coated golden. If you did, then I must be the cold and exploding with the commode.
With Charles Davis, as always,
I'm Brandon
Gauden.
Charles,
you talk about storylines.
I got to play smart.
Begins and ends with our two quarterbacks, certainly two of the best in the business.
And nowadays, I don't think you can get by for long periods of time without a top-flight quarterback. The way the game is played, with all the responsibility he has and how the game flows through him, if he's not on the top of his game, your team's not going to benefit at all.
And we are underway in Buffalo. And he's up past the 20 to the 22-yard line. To throw right away is Vic.
Oh man, it's Randy Moss, hot almighty. All right.
Randy Moss, and now he has our full attention with his first grab of the game.
Well, he's one of only two players to go a whole season averaging over 100 yards receiving and average a touchdown per game as well. That's a pretty impressive stat.
All right, I was lying. I was JKing. All right, apparently this dude doesn't even run the ball.
The connection working, his second catch in a row, first down. So we just called his name on the previous snap, and they go right back to him, Charles, for a second consecutive completion.
Yeah, I think what we're discovering on this drive is that he feels like he has answers no matter what defense you throw up there. He reads it, finds the open spot, and is available for
the What
completion.
The fuck was that?
That throw by Vic, incomplete.
I mean, I was coming, but I wasn't coming that fast. Or was I? Last night I was. Today, not so much.
That gives them a quick chance to regroup and try and mount a stand before they're backed up even further.
Vic with the incompletion on first down, and now that leads to second and 10. Here's a play fake as they set up to throw. That's swung out wide to Sanders. 9 yards, and that leaves him just short, so it'll be third and less than a yard.
I like it. Get everyone involved in the passing game, and you know you can create those great mismatches throwing it to your guys out of the backfield.
And on the first drive, that can also help establish some rhythm, right?
I think so. It gets everyone involved. They feel like they're part of it, and really gets them amped up.
Ooh, that was wide.
And they'll try and run the action to pick it up. Or get this up to the 34. The good lane opening up right away for it. Nice pickup. 10 yards and a first down on the keeper. There's Vic.
Siéntate, por favor.
Back-to-back nice gains. That one for 14 yards and another first.
And this was a nice example of an offensive coordinator scheming his gun here, but just a little underneath route, just trying to free up some space. And it worked awfully.
Ooh, got him.
There he goes. They bring a man off the corner that time, and he gets home for a loss of 6. This short pass into the hands of Njoku. A minimal gain there on the 8th play of the drive.
Got to give credit where it's due. Really nice defense on that play. The pitch and catch was successful, but not any run after it.
Now on third and long, they'll look to throw. He's got his target. That's complete.
That was a good play. That was good.
He does pick up the first. A gain of 22.
That's a big conversion there on third down. And this has been a great opening drive. You know, at this point, they'd hate to settle for three, but they've created a fresh set of downs and a first and goal.
Play action now. Vic steps away. To the end zone, but it's incomplete.
Chances are good. He's going to be a very busy guy. 2 catches already in this opening drive, and they were looking his way for a third.
I think they put this defense on notice that that could be a really, really frequent combination. They'll go again from the 3 here on second and goal. To throw, Vic.
That was a good play.
Touchdown.
That was good.
And the Browns have taken the early lead on the road here in Buffalo. Kevin Stefanski going to leave the offense out to go for two. They'll look to throw. It's caught. And it's 8-0. The Browns kicking team out there now as they'll send this one away.
Ooh. Oh, where the fuck did he come from?
To the other side of the field across the 50.
Well, he gave up the first touchdown of the game, but how about the response? Big time return. Now it's their chance to try and put points on the board.
On first and 10, here's Vic. They'll set up the screen to McCaffrey. On the move past the 40. And down around the 37. First down, Titans gain of 12.
And that's not a play that you see all that often at the start of a drive, but some teams, they don't mind doing it. And that one, well served by the offensive lineman. They showed the pass, and then they got out into space. If we get some good blocks downfield, we'll let the player to be successful.
And he's taken down, but not before reaching the 10-yard line. A really good pick
right
at the 28 yards. One quarter down, 8-0 the score. Second quarter now, Titans in possession of the football as they go to work on a first and goal. Trying to run McCaffrey. He is going to be stuck cold behind the scrimmage. Quinnen Williams, so hard to block, and he shows it that time, making the tackle for loss. Second down, Vic. This will be caught just inside the 10. And it looks like he'll be just a yard shy of the 5 here as he's out at the 6. The catch good for 6 yards, but now it's third and goal.
And when you run a drag route like this down near the goal line, you're hoping maybe you get an inadvertent pick to set your man free. A lot of people call them natural screens. Well, this is what the
should I go for it? Yeah, I'm going to go for it.
Vic with the incompletion there on third down.
That's going to hurt a bit because they needed to come through with a completion there. Now a drive that started with great field position is facing fourth down.
The offense stays out there. A big challenge here from this far back, but they're going for it on fourth and goal.
That was perfect coverage. I had nothing. Fuck me, nothing.
And this Browns defense stands tall. The Browns drive about to get started. And they'll be looking to make this a two-score advantage. Had the touchdown on their first drive, Charles. Hey, they can get up 2 scores here on the road. That's a heck of a start.
And not only have they thought about it, I wonder if they visualized it. I remember playing, and they used to turn the lights out in our meeting room and run through a situation like this and say, just think about what it would be like to be up on the road and take the crowd out of it. Maybe they did something like that.
First down throw coming for Vic. That's down the field of Moss complete. Taken down before they reach the 50. Another big play as they get 28 out of that one. Vic now from the 50. This is incomplete. Physical play on the football there, and it's second down.
And I think they'd be well served to take that type of a physical approach against him the rest of the game. He's had his way so far. But on that last one, that worked quite well for the defense.
Ooh. Yeah, needed that.
The defense rising to the challenge
Richard sending him back on the sack.
Yeah, some real defensive resistance there, saying not so fast to a good drive. They had marched to the end zone the last time out.
Third and long for Vic.
That was bad. All right, I guess I'm going to, I guess 4 wins in a row is enough.
This first half, and the Browns have taken a 2-touchdown lead now. Kevin Stefanski going to leave the offense out to go for 2. They'll try and throw for it. And the conversion good. He's got it. So the lead swells to 16-0. The Browns kicking team out there now as they'll send this one away. From a yard or two deep, here comes a return. And he will be brought down here inside the 20. Good coverage as he's dropped at the 17. Tennessee offense about set and ready to go. They've got some stuff to build on from that last drive because they moved the football, CD, and then they tried to go for it on fourth down, didn't convert, probably left a bitter taste in their mouths.
I would say so, and I think that they go out in this series determined for that not to happen again. In fact, they don't even want to get to a fourth down opportunity. They just want to make sure they get it done within the parameters that they've set for themselves. Run their offense, get it into the end zone. Yeah, I think a little bit of determination and a dash of anger.
Now, meanwhile, the throw by Vic, incomplete. It was knocked away.
Well, he certainly thought he had a window to push that ball downfield, but as soon as he released the throw, the corner was there to slam that window shut.
Vic goes play action, sliding out of the pocket. Able to find the open man. That's complete. But it will be correct. Well on the field right around the 40-yard line. Vic will look to throw on first down. Looking for Cooper, and it's intercepted. And he'll take this across midfield and inside the 45. So here's Vic following the interception. That's going to be caught by Moss. He'll get this one down near the 20-yard line, just shy of the 20. A well-executed 22-yard gain. Vic now. And that's complete to Sanders. And he'll get this down to the 10. A solid pickup of 12 yards, and now they're knocking on the door. Now a timeout taken. Perhaps a chance for one more quick play and then another timeout if they hurry. We'll see. So even though it's first down, here's the field goal unit on now to try to get 3 before halftime. From the left hash, should be a fairly easy one here. And the 10-year bet knocks it through the goalposts, and that will extend their lead even further. So, Charles, they get to them with their first turnover of the game and then make it hurt a little bit extra with a field goal.
And anytime you give the ball up, what's the first thing a coach tells his defense? Don't let them score off of this. You've got to put out the fire. In fact, in 2021, that's what one NFL coach termed his defense. The firemen, go out there, guys, and don't let them put some points on the board.
Oh, a good-looking return set up here. So we've hit intermission. It's halftime. This is the NFL.
I think it's the ball to have.
And it's a presentation of EA Sports. And we welcome you back live now inside the booth alongside Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gordon, set and ready to rock for the third quarter.
The Titans going to get the ball to start the second half, and they trail here as we get back to it on EA Sports. Here's Christian McCaffrey to return it.
And the fuck was that?
Up to start this drive as he's taken down right around the 15.
In this position, trying to get back into the game, teams are looking for a spark from their special teams. That's not what they got, though. They got a setback, and they have a long field to cover if they want to try and put points on the board.
The Titans offense set to begin the drive. They look up at the scoreboard facing that deficit. A three-score game, Charles, but look, there's plenty of time to go here. The old football cliche that comes to my mind is you can't get it all back at once. They probably need something, though, out of this drive, at least 3 points.
Are you trying to say that there's no three-score drive on that play sheet for any of those coordinators? They just don't have it, right? You're trying to get it all back. You know you can't get it back in one drive, but maybe cut into it a little bit, as you just suggested. Try and create a little bit of momentum, a little bit of a spark, and then maybe that'll carry over.
It gets man to play.
And he's going to be taken down, but there's a penalty flag in the backfield. Is this a hold, or did they rough the quarterback?
And that flag's on Myles Garrett, and we know he's got a nose for getting after the quarterback, but that time, even though he's going to protest it a little bit, he's a step late, and they hit him with the penalty.
So a critical mistake, roughing the passer. Now it's first and goal. Here's Michael Vick.
That is incomplete. He couldn't hold on through the contact. Brings up second down.
When you run in the slant, timing is everything, and against that man coverage, there was no space available, and incompletion as a result.
And this is going to be intercepted. Teron Johnson able to pick it. And the Browns are going to take possession here. It's a touchback, and they'll take over at the 20-yard line. The Cleveland offense ready to go. And they had the big halftime lead. Their defense just helped them out further by forcing the turnover, so things are starting to look pretty rosy.
They certainly are, but they've got to be careful about getting complacent, though. They still need to go out and run their offense efficiently.
Tackle made there by Myles Garrett. In the first half, he was held in check on the ground, but despite that lack of production, they still have the lead.
Yeah, and they've got to feel fortunate about that. If they could actually get production from their lead horse, that would help open up this offense and widen this margin, too.
Well, you got to think, Charles, that one's on the quarterback, because everybody was up at the line of scrimmage. He just didn't call for the snap in time.
Yeah, I think he needs a little bit better awareness out there, because you got to know when the clock's in single digits and either snap it or get a timeout called if you have one.
Vic on second down.
Like a running back going through the line, quarterbacks have to be aware of protecting the football as well. He left it exposed that time, wound up having it knocked free, but fortunately had an alert teammate who was able to get it.
So possession still theirs, but now they face a third down. Now here's Vic. Pass taken in by its big tight end. And he is going to have a Browns first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
We often hear the phrase sure-handed tight end, and he certainly fits into that category. Plus, he's got a quarterback who knows to look his way when they need a big pickup. And on this play, he finds him for the first down.
They just get the playoff. Now Vic, a hit as he throws there, incomplete.
I see the surprise in your face there, partner. That is a rare incompletion from him. He's been on point this entire game.
He has percentage completion-wise way up, not that time. We're in the third quarter in upstate New York with a second and 10. Vic to throw it. And he'll be hit as he releases it, and that'll fall incomplete.
You can tell they wanted to get that ball downfield, but they had nothing working in the secondary, so he dropped it off to the running back. That one ended up incomplete.
Vic to the air again. Open man, that's Cooper. Touchdown.
Amari Cooper, 54 yards. And the Browns are able to stretch out their lead.
Yeah. GG's, buddy. GG's. So I won four in a row, and then I just got my ass fucking whipped. I mean, when I whip, I got my ass just whipped. Shit wasn't even close.
With Charles Davis, as always, I'm Brandon Gordon. And Charles, you talk about storylines in this one. I think it begins and ends with our two quarterbacks, certainly two of the best in the business.
And nowadays, I don't think you can get by for long periods of time without a top-flight quarterback. The way the game is played, with all the responsibility he has and how the game flows through him, if he's not on the top of his game, your team's not going to benefit at all.
I'm tripping. I thought it said that he's got 330 points already, but apparently that's his name on here. I was like, what the fuck? Hey, I never claimed to be smart. I may have a 142 IQ, but I'm a fucking retard sometimes.
And we'll see a return here from the end zone. But ultimately cannot get this out to the 25 yard line.
My cats are fucking destroying my living room right now. Yeah, I haven't broken down the chair for my gaming, or the box for my gaming chair yet. And they are fucking going to town on it right now.
To throw right away is Vic. And it's got his target. It's Vernon Davis. And the result here, a pickup of 8, leaves him with 2 to go on second down. Second and a couple. Play action now, Vic. It's complete. He dials up Davis once more.
I wasn't even supposed to run that, but I wasn't going to get shit on that run play, so I had to go to something.
It's a former defender because that big man did not want to go down and refused to go down. If you're a defender and you get the right angle on a big tight end like him, he can run right through you like you're not even there.
and he did a lot of that on that play.
They tried well on first down, but this one going to lose a couple yards as they get him behind the line.
An interesting and intriguing decision there defensively because they kept extra DBs on the field despite seeing the multiple tight end look that came out for the offense.
I thought they were going to switch out, but I didn't know if they felt they didn't have time or what the case was.
Well, in any event, the extra speed allowed for great penetration as they stuffed that one behind the line of scrimmage.
Now, meanwhile, the throw by Vic incomplete. It was knocked away.
The coverage keyed in on him since that last completion his way. He earned a little more attention on that route, and that made it a lot tougher to get a clean throw his way.
An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down. Throwing, Vic.
Work in the middle of the field, and it's going to be incomplete.
And that'll wind up moving the chains again as the tackle's going to be made at the Seahawks 28. The Mills passing game, get them down the field. They've got another first down. Vic readies to throw. It gets a complete to Harris. And it's good for a pickup of 10 yards. And they'll leave it with a second and just a few inches left.
Well, this has certainly been a
nice and they're tearing the box up again. Fucking that box all the way up.
Involved in the passing game. That's going to cause a lot of consternation on the defensive side. You've got to cover him, too. That makes things really difficult.
And before they get it inside the 10 to the 7. It's a good gain of 11, sets them up first and goal.
A lot of precision being shown on this opening drive. They've been methodical, they've been crisp, and as a reward, they're going to be set up with an early first and goal.
First and goal, a chance for an early statement here on the road. They'll throw again. Here's
there's no way in real life that's a fucking interception. Come on. He wasn't even looking.
Are going to get the football here as the ball will come out to the 20. Not something you see very often from a quarterback of his caliber, an opening drive interception.
Oh, there's no doubt in my mind that even he's surprised at how that one played out. But we know this guy is not going to stop him from continuing to fire as this game goes along. Probably give a little nod of respect across the field for that one. Let him know he'll be back the very next series.
And Vic's throw there incomplete.
Part of what we're seeing so far is the defense is certainly coordinated. Both levels doing their jobs in tandem. The back helping the front helping the back. The pressure got home on that last play and forced him to try and throw through contact and short of the sticks.
On second down, Vic again. So going to get him as he goes down. How to approach this? Third down and 16 yards to go. From the shotgun, it's Vic. And it's incomplete. So it doesn't look like they're going to be able to build off the turnover.
Well, the defense certainly did its part to get up the football. But you're exactly right. It looks like they're going to have to punt this one away. And it's not a turnover, but doesn't it feel like one after grabbing the momentum with the defensive play?
Yeah, and they had all that momentum after getting the football, and now zapped right back in the other direction. A well-hit ball there. 50 yards on the punt, free on the return. And out will come the offense as they take over. Buffalo offense ready to go for their next drive. Remember last time out, they threw the interception on their first drive. Good news. Oh, he tried to fit it in on the slow. And his guys are going to take over at the 39-yard line. So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a first and 10. Vic with a give to Sanders.
Nothing.
Siéntate, puta. No cutback lane to be found whatsoever. Second and 10. Looked like he was trying to bounce it outside, but no success.
Yeah, sometimes you got to just figure out where you're going to go, and sometimes you just have to take it to another spot. And trying to get it outside, the defensive pursuit was there and just ran him down.
Well, he's finally taken down. It's a big game there. It turned out to be the final play this first quarter. No score. Juwan on EA Sports. Seahawk football here to start quarter number two.
as they've got it with a first and 10. Another run here with Sanders. And they get to him quickly here as he stopped right around the 13. 2 yards on the pickup there. It'll be second and 8.
That's a good play by the guys on the defensive side of the ball. Held them to a gain of 2. And that changes the playbook a little bit now for the guy calling plays. Second and 8. Now he's got to probably think about going to the air instead of maybe staying with the ground game.
It's a second down run with Sanders. And he'll be taken down here at about the 11. 2 yards on the carry there, and it's going to lead him to third down.
Defensively, we always know that he gets tough and runs some hard, and I think the way that he gets there is he understands what an offense is going to do before the ball's even snapped. A great job of scouting.
That was a good play. Can't even be mad at that. That was good.
And the Seahawks post the first points of the ball game as they take the lead here in this second quarter. Extra point by Carlson, up and good. And that makes the score 7-0. Now after the touchdown, ready to boot it away, Riley Dixon. And a nice return sets him up pretty good here right at the 30-yard line. The Bills come to the line to start their next drive. But for this offense, Charles, you got to think kind of crucial here to put something together on this drive, because remember last time out, they threw the interception on the very first play.
And you can't afford to let this defense keep building any more momentum. They're right now. To me, it's time to attack and take some of that momentum back. But make sure you're selective in doing so. Understand where you want to throw the football and make sure it's open before the ball leaves your hands.
A second down throw for Vic. And he takes a shot on the release as this will be incomplete.
Locked in completions on first and second down. It certainly seems like a reflection of what we've seen so far in this game. The defense took her to the punch so far. Let's see if they can get something going here on third down.
Now they face a third and 10 after back-to-back incompletions. To throw, Vic. He's got his target. That's complete. And he is going to have the Bills first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. So he turned to a trusted, familiar face in that third down situation. It paid off.
Yeah, you go to your veteran receiver in that spot, so you can't underestimate him when he's on the field defensively. Make sure you know where he is, because he understands how to get open in key situations.
First down, Vic. Oh, the ball comes out on the hit, but they'll say it's incomplete.
Well, there's an incompletion, partner, and the struggles through the air continue, because so far their lack of passing production has led to a lack of points.
Vic with the incompletion on first down, and now that leads to second and 10. They'll bring one of the tight ends in motion left. On second down, McCaffrey.
Ooh, okay, I'll take that.
The Bills have the first down.
Exactly what they needed right there, because they needed to use the ground game to take some pressure off, because the quarterback's been struggling a little bit.
On play action, Vic. Open man complete downfield to Davis. And finally down he goes as they work it inside the 10 to the 7. That's good for 28 yards. Now we
give right side McCaffrey, and he is met in his tracks behind the line of scrimmage. Call it a full 3 yards in the wrong direction there. Brings up second down.
Tackling's obviously critical down near the goal line. That was great work there to make the hit behind the line and make sure he doesn't get any further. Did a really nice job wrapping up and not letting him loose.
They stay on the ground this time. It's Williams. And they go the wrong way on this one. Losing yardage back at the 12.
Well, they went back to it, but the results were similar. So I highly doubt they'll get another opportunity here on third and long.
And now can they reverse the trend on third and goal with the last two plays having gone backwards? There's Vic. That's going to be...
Needed that.
Thank you very much.
And the Bills are on the board here in the final minute of the first half. Got a little time left on the clock, so on the other side, they're thinking, gosh, we'd like to get that lead right back.
Yeah, thanks for pointing that out. Here I am, go ahead and tapping out the first half.
Well,
there's still time. They've got to make a decision about what they want to do on the kickoff, where they want to let their return guy touch it.
Extra point splits the uprights, and that is going to tie our game as we approach halftime. So I'll leave it at 7 now as they kick it away. And just shedding him off there. And they'll start this drive just across the 30. Pretty nice work on the return. Coming to the line here to begin their next drive, the Seahawks offense. And with a little under a minute to play, they may be looking to pick up some yardage here, maybe try and come up with a field goal to seize the lead before intermission. Now, meanwhile, the throw by Vic, incomplete. It was knocked away.
Certainly looked like someone was very confident in his ability to fit that one in. I would say he was overconfident because there wasn't a whole lot of separation there. Had that one covered pretty well downfield and knocked it away.
Vic with the incompletion on first down, and now that leads to second and 10. Looking to throw. Now the Seahawks going to use the first of their timeouts as they'll stop it with just over 40 seconds to go in the first half.
Some guys just simply have it, and Randy Moss is one of those guys. His big playability, once again, on display right there.
That's what he's known for. He averaged 15.6 yards per reception during his playing days. Highest career yards per catch average for any player with 900 or more receptions. Play defensively on first down as this is knocked away and incomplete.
Trying to get that one to his tight end, and they've been trying to get the ball to him, but as of yet unable to successfully complete one. But you know, there's usually a nice comfort zone in throwing to the tight end. Great sight lines, usually right in the middle of the field.
Throwing again, Vic on second and 10, being chased out left. That's the try. But inside the 15-yard line. Big yardage there on the scramble. It gets him a first down.
Well, here's your first example of how this guy can beat you in more ways than one, because they took away his arm, but he was more than happy to dissect him with his legs for that first down pickup.
From the 13 mile, they work on first and 10. Working out of the gun, Michael Vick. And his throw is going to be incomplete.
As a corner, you have to be able to run with guys step for step downfield of man coverage and make up ground quickly in zone. You have to put yourself in position to make plays, just like that one we saw there.
Here's second and 10. Vic now. And that's complete to Sanders. Touchdown, Seahawks.
Fuck.
So the first half is winding down. And the Seahawks have taken the lead here in the final stages of this first half. Extra point by Carlson, up and go. And that makes the score 14-7.
So not much time to speak of remaining in this first half as the kick's away. And he won't get this to the 20-yard line as he's down at the 19. Buffalo offense ready to go for their next drive. And the ball backed way up. So thinking with this amount of time on the clock, probably just sit on it. But we'll see these two teams go.
Yeah, I don't think you want to overthink it in this situation. Either side of the ball. Just go ahead, finish up the half, and get on it and talk about it.
Now the job becomes twice as difficult now after the sack. It's second and 20 from the gun. Vic. Jackson picks it. It's Jackson back in the closing stages of the first half. Wow, a big mistake there. Late interception this first half, and that could lead to a field goal try the other way.
Yeah, I think at this point you just had to say, let's take a knee and go in the half and regroup. Let's just talk it over a little bit. I wonder, partner, was the analytics coach in his head a little bit? Maybe go ahead and press it and try and get some points. While the old school coach probably would have said, take the knee, let's get out of here.
Now we could see points the other way here. Suddenly it's first and goal after the interception. A quick change in the situation here. This will be the final play of the half. Vic, oh, he tried to fit it in on the slide, but it's intercepted. But he will be with no time remaining.
Oof, that was close. That was too close.
That's it for the first half. Two more quarters to go. We'll have plenty more to see after the break. Welcome back. Halftime over. We are ready for quarter number three alongside Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gordon. As they say here in London, all to play for as we are back underway in the second half. And he'll take it up past the 25 to the 26-yard line. Here's the Seattle offense ready to get this drive underway. Now, both of these defenses have been stifling these last few drives offensively, just not able to get anything going. So what needs to change?
I have a lot of the guys will go back and review, so to speak, because everyone has someone assigned to it. How did each play work? Okay, what do we use that kind of worked for us during this game? Try and get back some of those plays, as well as the possibility of showing something you haven't shown already in this game and trying to change things up.
We'll see if they take the advice of Mr. Davis. On first and 10, it's Sanders. Another strong game. Two points, they've moved it a combined 33 yards.
Sometimes it's hard to believe, but there are times this game is about patience, isn't it? Is that the game he expected? But that run there, that may get him going.
I was just going to say, maybe that gives him a little juice, because you're right, he struggled, especially in that first half.
Yeah, I know the great ones always think to themselves, just hang in there. I'm just one big carry away from busting this open. That's a good start for him. Well, you certainly have to give a little credit here because they're playing this game now at their pace. This is ball control football, sustained runs, taking their time, and making it work.
And he works it to the 30-yard line here, right at the 30. They'll get three as the drive continues. It's a first down.
Not your normal call in short yardage, but the toss works very well there. Big people out in front being physical, and they pick up a first down.
Now a dump off here complete. Again, a three runs, but this time they double up and pick up six. He's already proven to be a factor in the running game on this drive. Now he gets involved in the passing game.
I think what we're seeing here is a modern version of workhorse in the NFL, being able to run it and catch it with equal proficiency.
He is taken down at the 21 after a short gain of two.
Brandon, one thing about blitzes, they really confuse offensive linemen at times, and what you have to do is not get on the guy right in front of you. If you don't, you saw the end result. Defensive tackle ended up making the play.
On third and one, here's Finn. Blitz coming in down the goes. So here we go. The offense is going to stay out there. They're going for it on fourth and eight.
Nope.
And the Bills are going to stop it as they call the timeout.
It's just their first, so two remaining as they burn one here in this third quarter. Out is Carlson now for the Raider field goal. And this will be a 45-yard attempt. And it is gone. Oh, that one looked to be in trouble the whole way. It does get over the ball. And they will move up by 10 now, 17-7. Well, they picked up right where they left off in the first half. First drive after the break, they come away with three and increase that lead.
Yeah, and you just want to keep building on that lead, don't you? Whether it's 6 points or 3 points, take everything you can get, keep maneuvering, keep adding to it, keep making it difficult for them to come back.
The Bills come to the line to start their next drive. And their deficit a little wider now than it was at halftime following the field goal a moment ago.
But the goal is still the same because you know they want to come out and establish a really nice second and get going. Make no mistake about it, though. Kicking field goals, not in their game plan. They need to get the ball in the end zone.
Now here's Vic. The Seahawks defense gets to him and they bring him down. William, the refrigerator Perry, picks up his second sack of the afternoon.
So a quick, easy analysis about why they've struggled so far. They keep putting themselves in third and long situations. They just took another sack right there.
And the offensive film session tomorrow may be a little longer than it normally is.
Not a lot of positive grades will be handed out thus far.
They'll set up the screen to McCaffrey. And he's going to get this to about the 20, but that is well short of what he needed. 5 yards, not enough. And it'll be fourth down.
And that's a play that's not uncommon on third and long because the offense is just hoping that somehow they can get a guy in space and follow some blockers downfield. Does a pretty nice job there getting a few yards, but he ends up getting stopped before he can get the first down.
This short pass into the hands of Njoku.
Got it. And he is going to need a bit.
First down as they find a way to convert there on fourth and six. And the Seahawks are going to take a timeout here on defense. It's just their first, so two remaining as they burn one here in this third quarter. A toss to the wide side. This is Williams. And that's the 40 before he's out of bounds.
Todd, if you want more carries, I think we saw him get him. Showed that he's got the fresh legs, and he picked up the first down on that run. Don't just ask for them. Show them that you're supposed to get the ball back.
And as they come to the line, they will not be able to get off another play as time has run out on this third quarter. You are watching Madden Ultimate Team on EA Sports. A couple of first downs has the football positioned at the 43 as they come up first and 10. Vic to throw it. Buying time to his left. And they'll get this well past midfield before being stopped just before the 35. So from Seahawk territory now, it's first and 10 at the 36. Flush to his right. And that one going to come up short. Low throw.
Well, a momentary speed bump there with that throw, partner. The defense had other ideas, and they're trying to mount a small stand before this drive reaches the end zone.
A toss to the wide side. This is Williams. And he'll get three down to the 34-yard line.
I think if we put together a job description for a middle linebacker, we would start with being able to hold down things in the middle of the line of scrimmage and be able to take off blockers. But how about the guys who can go sideline to sideline and make plays?
Love a guy that can do that. We saw a perfect example of it right there. And now they're running up, moving the chains again as the tackle's going to be made at the Seahawks 22-yard line. 12 yards there as they keep this drive rolling. It's another first down. And in a two-score game, obviously, every play, every third down, like we saw there, magnified. Big pickup.
It was a huge pickup. What they really want, though, is to not even get the third down. They've got to maximize time and conserve as much as possible.
That throw by Vic, incomplete.
He did a fine job there of not hitting it before the ball arrived, and I've got to tell you, you can often mistime that play because of the angles of approach. When you're going to get him, sometimes you panic as well and think, I've got to be there right now. Instead, in this case, timed it perfectly.
He fucking ran backwards. What the fuck?
I really like the angles that the tacklers came from on that play. They secured inside, took away the cutback. The sideline's there, so you can only go so far outside. They were able to close in and tackle him for a loss.
Yeah, they used your boy over there, the 12th man. Sammy sideline, right?
Sammy sideline. You know something? He tackles pretty well, too.
He's tougher than an airport steak.
Throw right side, come up by Davis. We'll get this to the 17. Well, showing what he needed. Desperation time. Vic on fourth down. Steps away to his left. The Bills drive stalls out on fourth down. And this long drive is going to wind up yielding nothing. So now with a little over 2 minutes to play, the road back gets very difficult.
Difficult, but still not impossible if they go ahead and play this thing out. Now the defense has to come up big. They've got to go for the strip of the football on each and every snap to try and give themselves a chance.
Henry Toto got in there behind the line of scrimmage that time. 2 minutes left to play in this football game here on EA Sports. So it's Seahawk football as we march toward a conclusion. Second and 12, and you'd have to assume another all-out effort to stop the run is coming. There's Michael Vick. And he's going to hook up with his big tight end to play. And he gets this one just shy of the 35 to the 34. From the 34 now, here's first and 10. They'll run with Sanders up the middle, and he slips up past the 45 before being tackled. 65 yards rushing for him now on what was his 10th carry of the ball game. 5 points of contact necessary at this stage as they'll run on first down. And the Bills will use the second of their timeouts as they'll top things over prior to this upcoming second down play. Another run with Sanders. He's going to have to protect the football and take his lumps here at this stage of the game as they stop him behind the line.
That's a tough one right there. He ran right to the teeth of the blitz as the linebacker was freed up in order to stuff that one for a loss. I think quarterbacks got to see that. Got to find a way to audible into something a little more advantageous.
Vic to throw. Nowhere to go here. He lost the football. And that was being picked up by the offense. But here in the final 2 minutes of the game, this will be blown dead. Only the fumbler can advance the football. So this will go back to the spot of the fumble itself. Dixon, the punter, is on as he sends it away. Only 29 yards on the punt there. Definitely not his best. And they will take over first and 10. Buffalo offense ready to go for their next drive. They can't do much at this point, partner. This one is going to go down in the loss count.
You don't make up for what has happened during the game. In this sequence here, maybe you hand it up and let someone run the ball if you so choose. But otherwise, just kneel down, call it a day, and try and prepare going forward.
They'll try again here, second and 10. Here's Vic. Open man downfield is Davis.
And the offensive center itself right now, over there with all this easy because he was wide open. And once he made the catch, plenty of room to work his way downfield. That was a breakdown on the defensive side of the ball, one that they want to fix immediately.
So the victory here for Seattle, and it was their defense that really made the statement after the break. They pitched the second half shutout.
Yeah, think about the team that just got vanquished. They did score in the second quarter. Do you think they thought at all that that would be their last?
These midfield picks suck. What's the point? Ooh, 78 overall. Man. Alright, let's play one more, then I'm gonna be done for the day.
With Charles Davis, oh, as always, Christ, I'm Brandon Gordon. Charles, you talk about storylines in this one. I think it begins and ends with our two quarterbacks, certainly two of the best in the business.
And nowadays, I don't think you can get by for long periods of time without a top-flight quarterback. The way the game is played, with all the responsibility he has and how the game flows.
Dude, I'm here to have fun. If I lose, I lose. Dude, I ain't mad at it.
Your team's not going to benefit at all.
You're not
going to
have fun playing me.
Well, you could tell my 300 people watching you on Twitch right now.
Okay.
And we are underway in Buffalo. And he won't quite make it to the 25. They'll start this drive out on the ground. And a nice run past the 30-yard line there. Now second and three. Here's Mahomes to throw. And this one incomplete. Too much contact to hold on to that one, and it's third down.
That was all about the defender making life difficult for the receiver. Very tough for a guy to hold on to the football through all that contact. He ends up forcing the incompletion.
Third play of this opening drive as they're looking at a third and three. Now Mahomes has taken in by his big tight end. And he gets this from the midfield before it's brought down. That good for 19 yards as they pick up the conversion on third. Running right, here's Falk. Giving this one all the way down inside the 20. So the big play means just like that, that parade from the red zone now on the first down. That go right back to the ground with Falk. And they'll take it into the end zone for a regular touchdown. Marshall Falk, that 18-yard touchdown run. And the Raiders have taken the early lead on the road here in Buffalo. Going after it, right down the middle. And it's now a 7-0 game. Out is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. And he'll elect not to run with it. The fair catch will move this out to the 25-yard line.
This guy's a bit of a dick, huh?
Vic goes play action. And he lost the football.
He's picking up. We've seen this before. Can we make it just preach that mess and work on it all the time? So, well, you know there's going to be some traffic somewhere, but get to put it away and secure it as they try and get downfield.
On the give, here's Falk.
He'll be dropped at the 25 after a gain of 6. Second down at 4. Now a gift inside for 4. And he'll get it down this time to the 17. 72 yards rushing for him as he's got the afternoon off to a great start. Now a give left side to Falk. And that'll hurt the average a bit as this time they're able to get him behind the line. Looking at a second and 11 now after the loss. Now here's Mahomes. And this is caught. Touchdown. Raiders. Deshaun Jackson from 17 yards out. And the Raiders are off to a 13-0 first quarter lead. And Holly clanks it off the right upright, and it's no good. So with a missed PAT in his rearview mirror, he goes back out to kick this one off. And he'll elect not to run with it. And a fair catch on the kickoff will move the ball to the 25. Tennessee offense about set and ready to go. They find themselves in a good size hole here, and a good size hole early on in this game as they come up on first down. Vic's throw intercepted. Picked up by Champ Bailey. Now he's loose at the 40, and he will take this all the way down to the 38-yard line.
Dude, why are you being a dick? Like, it's not necessary.
Because, dude, this isn't fun for me, man.
Then fucking quit, you bitch.
Bro, head from it. Fucking some of your people, your viewers, donate some money, buddy, so you can do your team better, right?
So after the INT, here's Mahomes. He gets it complete.
Oh my God.
And he will score. Touchdown, Las Vegas. Deshaun Jackson. Two catches,
good
two touchdowns
Lord, dude.
So far.
See you, pussy.
You are the worst fucking human being I may have ever came across on this. I just want you to know. I hope your kids get fucking cancer.
I hope you get the fucking bird flu.
I've been chasing the dream, paper chasing, I just made it my thing. Got the bag, I just need me a ring. GML, hold it down for the team. It's a sweet right. Shout out to you, cause I'm locked in, man. I swear that I'm fucking up in the drip. I bet that you know that your force one got me walking like Paul's God's house, so I know that I'm chosen. Drake with me, man. I feel like the Rosen.